Hi there, how are you doing? Let's talk about computed properties in C#. I plan to talk about it in two parts. The first half is about what is it and what's the advantages of it. The second half are the caveats. Let's dive in. A computed property is a property that its value comes from a calculation. For example, in this person class, full name is not stored anywhere. It is instead calculated from first name and last name combined. There are benefits of using it. The biggest one is consistency. In this case, full name will never out of sync with first name and last name. Let's see it. Here, we first create a Smith object with the initial first name of Adam. And the full name is Adam Smith. Well, Adam changed his first name to Josh for whatever reason. And the full name becomes Josh Smith. As you can see, thanks to the computed property, the full name always changes along with the first name and last name. So far, so good. Before we move on to talk about the caveats, let's take a look at how is it implemented. Let's decompile it in the IO spy. Change to a version before computed properties are supported. As you can see here, it's just a property with a getter. I'll talk more about this later. For now, let's turn it all the way to C#1.0 and see how it looks like. Here we can see two backing fields respectively for first name and last name, but there's none for full name. Well, that is another small benefit that it doesn't need a backing field. At this moment, you may find the computed property attractive. Let's talk about the caveats. Let's see another example. We have a product class here. Every product has an ID property. An ID is calculated GUID when we create an object of the product. Here, I laid down two common ways of doing that. They look very similar. Only line A is shorter, and we all know it doesn't require a backing field. I think I've teased enough that there's a problem for that. And let's find it out. I wrote some unit tests. They look very similar. One goes against ID1, another goes against ID2. Let me start the debugger. Let's start by creating a product instance. We'll assign ID1 to a variable named product ID1. And we verify that they equals to each other. Now we do a similar assignment for ID2 and try to verify they equals. And no, they don't equal. Wondering why? Let's do the debugging again. This time, I'll set a breakpoint on product ID2. Let's go through the first part really quick. Here again, when ID2 is fetched, we got a new GUID. And it is assigned to the variable of product ID2. Now we are ready to compare the variable of product ID2 to the ID2 on the product. Once I click the continue, it came in to get another ID2. Since ID2 is a computed property and there's no backing field for it, the new GUID method here will be invoked again. Coming back here, the p.id2 is a new GUID, while the one in the variable hadn't changed yet. And there you see the mismatch. Now let's think about what just happened. We have very similar product code. We have very similar test code. One works well, one isn't that much. And that is the caveat. Okay, a quick recap. A computed property doesn't come with a backing field, and the value got computed every time when it is accessed. Since the syntax looks similar to other properties, you need to be very careful either reading the code from the existing code base or when you try to pick which property to use for your own code. Thank you for watching. I wish you enjoyed it. If you do, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Now, see you in the next video. Until then, take care.